Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to round five of Exterminators 4 here at Wagga Wagga, New South Wales. We've got a cracker matchup coming for you for the top table. We've got Rowan, who played in round four with Crusher Stampede, against Tim, who is playing Renegade Knights. It's going to be a massive, massive game here. It's going to be awesome to bring you this coverage. We are about to start the round timer as well. And it is started. And so we're going to swap over to the Wargaming screen. Okay. As you can see, the mission we are playing is Overrun, so it's scored hold two, hold three, hold more for primary, and the boys are going to start going through secondaries and deploying as such. I'm going to turn to them because I'm about to eat lunch, so we can hear what they're doing whilst I'm eating off camera. So let's tune into them and see how they're going, ladies and gentlemen.
Just got ruins. I think the bridges are just part of the ruins.
Just the ruin itself,
I think. Standard craters, ruins, standard pipes. The barricade rule, yep.
Yeah, so it'll be a bit of extra movement to go up and over it.
Yep.
So, would you be ready for me?
Yep, all good.
You'd think he's done this before, eh?
This is the third time.
That looks like a new terrain.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, absolutely, would max that.
Got three psychers, two of the characters, that's 8 points. I've got three characters, that's assassinate 10 points. Other than that, I don't really get so much more.
I've only got one character.
Should be able to hear them both now, chat.
Trying to think.
Sure.
What categories have got?
And it's also, it is hold one, hold two, hold three.
Yeah, it's hold two. Yeah.
Great. How good is that? Right?
Yeah. Yay! So, I can only pick from three categories. I've got to pick one from each. So I've got to pick the, unless I want to pick a boar.
There's the mission specific too, but that's about holding my things, I think.
It's garbage.
Yeah, it is pretty bad.
End of the command phase. No.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, too easy to counter.
So you've got the, Battlefield Supremacy?
Yes, that'd be Stranglehold, Engage, or Behind Enemy Lines.
Oh, then Purge the Enemy. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's what I'll normally take. All right, you got yours?
Yeah, I'm going to take Bring It Down. Surprise, surprise. I'm going to take Stranglehold, and I'm going to take Rod as well.
Cool.
Oh, you've got a score sheet? That is pretty cool.
Oh, look, I like it over the app. It's so much easier to check.
I think just for keeping track of it during the game?
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. The app's
Even
garbage.
The games where they've used the phones, like, I've still kept one of these just so I can
100%.
Know what's
And it's
going
easy
on.
For us both to look at it.
Yeah,
keep
absolutely.
A track of it, and also for Scotty to just come over and have a look.
Alright, just tell me yours again, sorry.
Okay, so I'm going to take Stranglehold.
Yep.
I'm going to take Retrieve Octarius Data.
Yep.
And I'm going to take Bring It Down.
Makes sense.
Yep.
So I've got here.
Yes.
Bring It Down.
Surprise, surprise.
Engage at all fronts.
Yep.
And grind them down.
Makes sense.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to have a say in who you think is going to win this matchup, there is prediction going right now.
We don't need to leave.
And
right?
You can put channel points on the line and win channel points if you predict correctly, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see them in. Foxbat Fly, thank you so much for the follow. Really appreciate that, and welcome to the chapter. Hope you're going to enjoy the coverage of this top table matchup for the event.
Aside, just because it's here. They're the same, so because.
Yeah.
I'm just going to map out it's a 12-inch deployment zone, I believe.
Yeah, 10-inch in, that's all it is. Yeah.
Oh, is it 10 inches?
It's 10-inch in, 12 inches from the middle. It's only a 44. Yeah,
of course it is.
It's not 48 anymore.
That always screws me up.
Yeah, that's all. Yeah, no dramas.
Behind the dice.
I was wondering if they were intentionally picking missions this tournament that only had the hold one, hold two.
I was hoping they were.
And then I got to this round and went, oh no, they just saved the hardest for last.
Well, look, I think it's going to be pretty negative for both of us.
Yeah.
So at least that's something. Yeah, I was thoroughly enjoying all the take and hold. It was awesome.
The only negative for me is missions I can't bank on Stranglehold, that's it. If I can bank on Stranglehold, I'd get that.
Yep.
But only if these objectives are sort of here.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's wasteful.
Okay, well, I will make a deployment. I'm going to put... these warriors just hiding in here.
Okay.
So they'll be just on the deployment line.
Sure.
Oh yeah, I guess your deployment will be over pretty quick.
Sorry?
Oh yeah, I was thinking, like, oh yeah, you've got, you know, 12 models, but no, you've got 3 units.
Yeah,
four
that's
units.
Right, yeah. I'll put 3 choppy dogs there.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Should I put him more there? Nah, put him there.
So just remind me, it's a thermal lance, right?
I think it's called a thermal lance, yeah.
And it's what, heavy three, heavy D3?
Assault D3.
And then strength 8 minus heaps, 4, D6 damage.
D6. So 30 inch range?
Yeah.
Half range, 2D6, pick the highest.
Old school melter.
The
I
old
like
one.
It.
Yep.
Cool, man. Right on. Another unit of warriors. Just hanging out back here. They will be on that objective, but hiding.
Yeah.
They're the just more. That's a unit of 2 choppy boys.
3.
Okay, cool. Yep. What's the range of your warlord's deny?
24. Just a normal.
Normal deny and no bonuses or anything. Just a,
no, it's just
straight
a
up. Okay, that's cool.
Just the other bonus he gets is a 5-up. In he gets a 5-up save against psychic mortals. So if you smite him or something.
Yeah, look. Might come up, but
yeah.
No. I'm gonna put these warriors back here.
See the synaptic.
Yes, they are. Yeah.
The synaptic link, that's what I'm thinking.
Correct, yeah. So the way that works is it's a 12-inch range.
Yeah,
but I can chain it through others.
It's all good. Yeah.
Just checking. All right, cool, that's a
third. I'll be using it soon, don't worry. I'm all over it.
You are thinking about getting into the Nid Zone?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
This is the only army I've got. I've had it for like 3 years.
Oh, really? Fair
so
enough.
I'm hoping to go to 2 armies when the raffle comes up. But.
So I change from Knights. I just keep playing Knights.
Oh, and why wouldn't you with the latest stuff, you know?
They're good now. They're really nice, yeah.
And this kind of list is just, it's just quality. Like my friend plays an Imperial version of this, right? One Preceptor and then 11 Small Knights. And it doesn't degrade as the fight goes on, right?
Yeah, that's
the
right.
The whole time you're going to have that many hard to kill wounds on
that's
the table.
That's right. Yeah, it's really, really potent.
Yeah. Oh, I'd rather not. It's going to be a tough game, I think, for both of us. I think the matchup is hard enough for both of us, but this map's also hard for us. So, hard guided.
I feel like the guy that has 16 supplements for his codex might win.
2. One's just a regiment of renown.
Yeah, so
you've got
3.
You've got one.
I've got a Psychic Awakening.
Well, all the Psychic Awakening stuff is also in the Octarius book.
Yeah.
That's just like a rewrite. So.
Oh, here we go. Gamey already.
Oh, you don't believe in me, Dom. I thought we were tight, man. I bought you a beer. And you bought me a beer. So, yeah, right, fair enough. All right, 6 Hive Guard back here doing Hive Guard stuff.
Yeah, righto.
I'm not touching the wall, so
yep.
You can't see me.
No worries.
The big fella.
Big dog can go here.
Tyrann FX is going over here.
Okay. It's a unit of 2, and I'm
that's
out.
You're done. And now you don't have any redeploys or anything like that, do you?
No.
Okay. I do, yeah. I can redeploy 2 units when the game starts.
Yep, no worries. This light really needs to be like here.
Yeah, I know. I think they suggested rotating it like to that, but that idea got shut down.
Need another table.
Yeah. I'm going to come back to him. See McCarron. Just take a few measurements here. So this is a 6-inch bubble of minus one to hit around this guy.
Yeah, okay.
And if I spend the CP for the minus one strength, it's around this guy.
Okay.
If you kill him, yeah, that bubble does go away.
Okay.
Okay.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, as the boys are finishing up deployment, let's go through Tim's list. We already know of Roland's
last game. So at the moment, that's all getting hit by all the negative stuff.
Okay. So if you do want to view it, it is in the Discord already, and I will put...
Oh, I can't have things hanging outside, can I?
I will put Tim's list in Discord now as well.
And then I've just
well.
Got two lictors, which will be coming in later.
Yep.
So I've spent 3 command points pre-game.
Yep.
I'll be starting on 9.
Okay.
And yourself?
So...
11.
He is running a 11. Super we'll heavy 11. Detachment.
Yeah, look, I...
Let's drop those guys a bit more. All right. So, we have got super heavy detachment. Oh.
Got a 5 and a 4.
I use a command point.
Why don't you spend all your command points to reroll that?
All right.
Oh, man. Sure, look, let's have a good game.
Oh, yeah, good game.
And let's just see how it goes. I'll go up to 10 CP.
And Rowan got turn one. Massive for him. I will go and get the secondaries and all that now as well. Let's see if it's updated in BCP2.
I'm not
so,
too bothered, actually.
Tim's list as Rowan starts his turn. He has got a super heavy detachment that has got a Night Desiccator with warp, haunted hull. It is the character Traitorous Lance, Thunderstrike Gauntlet, Vow of the Beast Slayer Warlord, and the Diamosis Relic. It is a House Iron class with an Abominable Constitution and Infamous Heraldry as a custom household. He has then got a unit of 3 War Dogs with Thermal Spears, Melter Guns, and Reaper Chainswords, followed by another Chain Cleavers, a second unit of those 3, a unit of 2 of those as well, and then a unit of 3 Moiraxes with double Lightning Locks as well. He does start on 11 CP, which we will update in here. And then Rowan's list is the exact same as before. If you need to view it, it is in Discord already. You just got to scroll up a little bit. And he does start on 9 CP. I will go get the secondaries now, chat, and we'll turn to the players as I do so that I can update the scores for you. It's going to be really interesting to see how the Crusher Stampede goes against the Knights here. I hope this is going to be a great matchup, and I hope you guys are going to enjoy watching this too.
Okay. This Tyrannofex is just going to move up to here.
Uh-huh.
The Demacheron is going to move 12. Move the dice too, put that stuff down.
Where's the back of him take you?
Yeah, cheers.
Back of him takes you.
Just to pretty much on that?
Yeah, pretty much on it. On
thanks.
It. Yeah, that little lippy bit.
I'm going to advance the Swarm Lord. He moves 9 inches plus 1, so 10. So in order to double move a unit, I need to be within 6 inches, but I think I'll be okay. 10 inches just gets him right up to the wall here.
Yep.
Flying Hive Tyrant will, he's got 16 inches of movement. He's just gonna pop up to here.
Uh-huh.
Try to be as hidden as he can. These wings will-
Obviously not touching.
Nah, just away a bit. Yep. I mean, you can see his wings, but what am I gonna do?
I know, yep.
Yeah.
That it is indeed, Squint Dog. That it is indeed.
7 inches. So he's just going to come up to here.
All right, I've got their secondary chat. I'm just going to the update them for you as well. And then we can go from there.
Normally, so that'll be 11. To here, and I've just realized I can't fit through that gap. So I'm gonna have to spend some movement to go over it.
Yeah,
minus two, so 6 inches. He's got 48 inch range guns. It's just a pain that I couldn't have gotten him further. He's just gonna come up to there.
Yep.
On the objective at least. Magnets.
Nice.
All right, these warriors are just gonna chill out. These warriors are gonna rod over here.
Yep.
And these ones, I'm just gonna move them a little bit, just so maybe a little bit more hidden. So everything's moved except for the hive guard. They're heavy weapons, so I don't wanna move them if I can avoid it. And now we'll go into psychic. So you might be in range for a few denies here. You'll be able to deny my hive tyrant or swarm lord. They have two spells each, so let's see if that comes in handy. All right. So I'll start off with the Malaceptor back here. He's gonna try and cast Onslaught, which is the advance and charge spell.
Yep.
I should roll two dice.
Two dice would be good.
That is a six. He does get plus one, so it does go off.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. So the secondaries both players are going for. They're both going for Bring It Down. So that's points for killing big units, which they're both going to be able to max against each other. Stranglehold for Rowan and Rod. So Retrieve Victorious Data is the three that he has chosen to take. He's definitely built his list with the two lictors to be able to do that. And then Tim has taken Engage on all fronts, so getting into all four quarters of the table, and then also grind them down as well to kill more than what Rowan does, which is really easy to do considering it's a lot harder to kill units of knights than individual knights. So it's going to be interesting to see how this is going. I keep thinking I should have went knights for a second army instead of third. Beast and Agarbox is just too tempting. Fair enough, Dragoon, fair enough. I really think Rowan needed to go first here to be able to even do stuff, and we'll see what he's able to do. So we're going to go back to Rowan as he's doing his psychic phase, and we will get into shooting shortly and go from there.
I need to see something, so
yeah,
that's all good. All right, I'll do some shooting now. He's got an 18 inch flamer, it's out of range. Barb Hyrajul really only has targets down here, so that's what he's going to shoot. So he's going to have each gun is 6 shots, so 12 shots.
Yep.
And this is going
to
be
T-Sizzle, thank you so much for the follow, and welcome to the chapter. Hope you're enjoying the coverage of this top table from the Exterminatus 4 ITC tournament.
One miss. Strength 8, so winning on threes.
Yep.
That is pretty good start. That's 9 out of 12 wounds. These are 2 damage each.
Yep. Ion shields.
Pretty good. Are those ones or sixes? The skulls?
They're ones.
Oh, okay, sure.
Oh, I didn't know about the skulls. Sorry, well, you see the sixes there.
No, yeah, I'm okay with that.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, he's dead. Explosion. No.
Okay.
God. I mean, the Games Workshop dice, for Christ's sake.
Oh, are you about the not using single dice? Keep using them if you want them.
All right, thanks. Yeah, no dramas. No, it's just about Scotty. Anyway, yeah. Dead.
Okay.
Yeah, normally I did ask for no symbol dice, but being Games Workshop, they do have the skulls on the ones, which is very commonplace and understandable for them. So it was just more if they could possibly do it, that would be great. But he's already started using them. We know that Games Workshop ones, they have the skulls on the one, so that is the standard for everybody, just to let you guys know.
The front one. Yeah, cool. So that will go into that armature. That ward object. That's correct. Yeah, with the hazard stripes.
Yep, I'll rotate his iron shield.
Sure. I'm just going to see if I get a CP for my relic. I do. All right. I will not spend any extra command points, because I think I'm going to need heaps of them. All right, so 12 attacks, hitting on threes, and the Warlord rerolls, full reroll.
Yep.
So a fair bit to reroll there. All right, so one miss. Strength is 8.
Yep.
We're winning on threes.
Mm-hmm.
That is going to be 8 at minus 2, so 8 on your 4 up involved.
Yep.
So you make 3, so they are D3.
Failed 5, yep.
Okay. So they're D3, I do get to reroll them. I'll just roll them all and reroll some of them. I don't think I need to.
Nah, so explosion.
That's 9, yeah, go for it.
No.
Alright. Okay. All right.
Don't.
Dropping the dice.
So we're going to move another 12 with him, and I can advance. Yep, so the Swarm Lord will get the Demon Caron to move again, and this time he's going to advance, so an extra 2 inches. So he's going to go 14 inches. Do you mind if I come around that side?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks, mate.
So he's going to go
pretty much just up the front bit of the objective there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I don't think I'm going to fire the Hive Guard again. I can for 2 command points, but I think I'm going to just try and save a bit of CP.
Okay, sure.
Maybe shoot him again next turn. So we're going to the charge phase now.
Yep.
I'm going to charge your big knight. Would you like to overwatch?
Yes, I will.
That's fair.
You never know.
Look, I mean...
1 point.
Yeah.
All right, heavy laser destructor.
Yes, sir. One hit.
One hit and gets one reroll.
That's so good. So I was going to grab my dice.
Yeah, sorry.
Okay, one hit. Nice. That's hit. Actually pretty good.
That's D3 mortals on top of minus 4 AP.
5 up invuln. I take it, so it's D6 plus 3 mortals?
Yep, so D6. 6 plus D3 for 2 mortals.
Okay, so that gets reduced to 5 because I'm minus 1 damage.
Yep.
So a total of 7 damage.
Yep.
That's a pretty big hit coming in. And some more stuff.
Heavy stubber.
Yes, old reliable.
Wounds you with the stubs.
AP nothing?
Nah, nothing.
3 up.
Oop.
Too excited. I'm good for the stubber. Okay, well that was a big hit actually.
That was big on the Dimmy. Is he going to be able to be effective going in?
This is all right, the charge.
Oh, this is now spicy team.
7 inches, I think we'll make it.
Very spicy.
He has no invuln in melee, right?
Correct.
Okay. I'm not going to do any mortals on charge impact or anything like that.
Okay.
Fight phase, I'm going to spend a bunch of command points on him.
Okay.
So at the moment he's still top bracket by a couple wounds. At the moment he's got 6 attacks plus 3 from my spell. He is strength 8. Hitting on 3s, his claws reroll all hits.
Yep.
Strength 8, I'll be winning on 4s.
Uh-huh.
Damage D3 plus 3.
Yep.
I'm going to spend, let me just get my book out for the right name for the stratagem.
Yeah.
This is some Crusher Stampede stuff, so.
Yeah, no problem, no problem.
All right, Thunderous Impact. I use it in the fight phase when one of my monster models has finished a pile-in move, so I'll pile-in to him. I choose one monster or vehicle unit within engagement range. Until the end of the phase, I can only attack that, but I get plus 1 to hit, wound, and damage rolls.
Yep.
So that would take me down to 9, and I really want to make sure this thing dies, so I'll spend 1 more on Voracious Appetite to reroll wound rolls. So I'll be hitting on 2s, rerolling 1s, wounding on 3s, rerolling fails. With 9 attacks.
Yep.
I do have a tail as well. I'll do it afterwards.
Yep.
All right. 2s, rerolling 1s. Okay, we all hit.
Yep.
And 3s, rerolling. We have 9 wounds. At AP3.
Yeah, okay.
So it's just time to show all those 6s, right?
6 up.
Yep.
And I pass 1, so it's 8.
All right.
It's 8.
They're going to be minimum 4 each.
Yeah.
So I think that'll be 8 times 4 is 20.
Yeah.
32.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'll see if I blow up.
Sure.
I don't.
No. And then I don't think I can engage the Morax. But if I can, I'll consolidate 3.
That is huge, ladies and gentlemen. That is the big knight, the warlord, already down. That is massive for Rowan. He needed to execute on that turn 1, and he had the plan in place, and he already did it.
Okay.
And he got there. Oh, that is such a big play. Such an important play as well.
Okay. That's my turn. So I will get I'll get my 3 for Stranglehold. I've rotted once.
Yep.
And I've got 3 points to bring it down.
Okay.
Over to you, Matt.
You got probably 5 points to bring it down.
I think over 20 is just 3 points.
Yeah, there's 2 Wardogs.
I killed the other Wardogs, so that'll be another 4 points.
Another 4, yeah.
Okay, so that'll go up to 7. Yeah, sorry.
to be fair, I just worry about at the end of the game and tick off 15 generally.
Yeah, I'm happy to do that. Yeah. Well, we're easily accountable at the end.
Yeah. Yeah, we can't forget it.
Yeah.
So, go up to 10 command points.
Sorry about that. It's pretty disgusting being able to do that, isn't it?
Don't be sorry. It's no drama. That's no. Why I need a first set.
Yeah, that's it, right?
It is what it is.
Sucks when it comes down to one dice roll, then.
Then advance this guy.
Yes.
Did pre-measure. I need a 3-inch advance to get in that quarter.
Go. Bring it up.
Yeah, you get a 5.
Nice one.
So, I'll put him up to a 20-inch move.
Come on up. Now, by all those melters are assault, aren't they?
Yep.
Okay, well, I'm very glad that I rotted with these guys, because
yeah.
You can kill now.
Very good rotting there. This is a tricky bit, moving into the right spots, being in the right place. To kill a Demon Charon.
Alrighty, chat. As you guys have clearly pointed out, that was huge. Such a massive play from Rowan turn one, being able to slingshot the Demi in, get into combat, and be able to deal some damage. But he also managed to kill another two War Dogs at the same time. So it means that he's already on 7 points for Bring It Down. So he's probably going to max it.
Yep.
Yeah, 100% Foolish Monk, 100%. It was so such a big move, and it was Rowan really had to execute on that, because otherwise the Dimmy's earned its points back in a half now. It's just whether it's going to be able to do anything else going forward.
Oh, Demi Charon's obvious good.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
It'll be pretty hard.
And
same for this side too. If you can see him, you can see him.
Yeah.
And so it's going to be really interesting to see what Tim does to come back from this and how he plays it, because it's 2.5 hours and he's already on bottom of one and he's lost his warlord.
He just does.
So having already killed one, Tim needs to kill two to get grind them down, whereas Rowan doesn't need to worry about that.
Sure, okay.
But so,
mate, so see
you can still see him, yeah. Cool.
It's going to be interesting to see how Tim plays this. He's a very experienced player with this army. He knows what he's doing. And it's going to be interesting to see how this shakes out, ladies and gentlemen. We're in for a cracker of a match, as we've already seen. So stick around with us. It's going to be awesome to see the outcome of this matchup.
He's not touching either. Yeah, go ahead.
I'll fall back to the terrain.
Yep.
Got a 13-inch move, so we'd have had 11 over the top of that anyway.
No problem. Almost looks like he can fit around it anyway. Close enough too.
So you can see the Demon Charon even through that, all that.
Yep.
So I'll just sort of move out and... Actually, I'll just touch the objective there.
Mm-hmm.
Just so I've got two on there, a bit of insurance.
Yes.
All right, shooting. He's going to put...
Yes.
So, is that in?
Yeah, close enough.
Yep.
So you're going to melt me good?
Melt a gun on top into him.
Yep.
And the thermal lance into the hive guard.
Sounds good.
So assault D3.
Yes. So this is into the hive guard?
Yep, hive guard.
Sounds good.
Yep. Two shots.
Yep.
Fours with a reroll.
Three reroll, yep.
No.
Yep. And this will be threes to win the T5.
Thanks, eight. Yep. No.
Okay.
Melt a gun on top. Hits.
T8, yeah.
He's going to put his thermal lance into the hive guard too.
Cool.
He didn't have to advance.
Correct.
So two shots.
Yep.
Two hits.
Nice. Far out.
That's Warhammer for you.
Yeah.
All right, we'll do him because he's the easy one. He's just going to shoot the Demon Charon. That's all he can see.
Cool. Lots of shots.
12 shots.
Yep.
With a reroll.
Yep. Lovely. These are strength 6?
Yeah.
Or 7. Okay. I'm T7.
There's 2 sixes, so 4 extra hits.
Of course.
And explosions.
Forgot about those. Lightning locks. Are those the actual, like, models for the lightning locks?
No. They're 3D.
How dare you? I was going to say they look really cool.
I like them too.
How dare you?
How did you hear me? So at fives?
Yep.
One, two, three, four, at cool. -2.
Cool. I do a before up involve.
That's right, yep.
And he's 2 damage. Is that right?
Yeah, just one.
Yep. I'll take one.
Yep. We'll go to the next Captain Obvious over here, which is him and him.
And that's Melter and Thermal Lens?
Yeah, both, okay. Everything, sorry. So D3 shots.
Of course.
Three? No, two.
Two hits.
Hits.
And three swing.
Tough seven, is he? Oh, cool. Threes.
Two. Awesome. Four up invulns, player one. So that's going to be 2d6, pick the highest, cool.
For five?
So that'll go down to down four, yeah. So I'll go down to six.
Six left?
Correct.
All right. Melt a gun on top. Get a reroll.
Reroll, yep.
The next one in line just next to him.
Yes, same target.
Three shots.
Yep. Hey, three. Here we go.
With a reroll.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Freeze. Whoop.
Just one.
Sorry.
No, you can't.
Dig him out of the corner.
Bring it on, man.
The five.
Go down to five, so he's gone one. Did you have a melter too?
Melter gun on top.
Yes, sir.
Misses.
Alright.
Put this lock into him now.
He fell back.
He's the fallback one, yeah?
Yep.
So that one then, the next one.
Sure.
Sorry.
That's okay.
I'm not normally engaged turn one. I'm not used to falling back right about a turn. With a reroll? Oh, this is terrible. Oh, yeah, I've got converted one.
Oh, no sixes either. That is...
I rerolled into a six.
So true. Okay, so I chucked two more in.
So there.
I only need one.
And five. And I've got zero?
On eight dice.
Wow.
No fives.
Scotty, there's something wrong with your dice tray, mate.
All the magnets underneath that he's turned off.
All right, the next lad in line.
Cool.
Melter's out of range, but correct. At the Dimacheron.
Yes.
Nothing like a bit of banter, chat. Nothing like a bit of banter. Okay.
Yeah, I'll keep that. One shot, only need one.
One hits. Hit.
Oh, no, sorry. And wounds.
There we go.
Pick all this up.
Oh, he's dead. No one's in range. I've only got a 3-inch lash out, so he does die.
Boop. And he's gone.
Got one more guy to shoot, which is the far lad.
Yes.
Let's see what I can reach. No.
Big guy.
The barbed hiradulis.
He will be minus one to hit from the Malanthrope. And he is T8,
no
just
worries.
So you're aware.
Yep. Probably the only thing I can shoot.
I think possibly, yes.
One shot. Hits.
Yep.
Doesn't wound him.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to blow two command points to advance and charge.
Oh, sweet. Over here?
Yep.
Okay, yeah, nice.
And I'm going to charge him.
Bring it on. Six. I reckon that's pretty close.
I think a six will do it.
Yeah, with extra.
Yep.
Okay. Bring it on.
They're three wounds, aren't they, each?
Three wounds each, five up in ball.
Alright. I'll use my smash profile.
Yes. And you're plus one to hit and plus one AP or something like that?
Plus one attack, plus one AP.
So five.
I'm hitting on threes, but I'll still get my reroll.
And strength.
12.
Yeah, so winning on twos. Cool.
With the reroll.
Alright, that's all you need.
Twos. Yeah, I get four. So four at more, yeah, on your invo.
Four five ups.
Yep.
They go down. Nice one. Very nice.
It's consolidating in
there,
but can't get grind because he killed too much.
I killed three, yes.
Yeah, so that gets me two on engage.
Correct.
Three for bringing down.
Only two for him. He's, I think it has to be 20 or more wounds.
Yeah. No, that's right, sorry. Nothing for grind. That's it.
Okay.
And you've got...
All right, so I'm on three, you're on three, so just 10 for primary.
10 for you?
Yeah, that's how done. Yeah. Five for two, five for three. All right.
Your rod's done once.
Yes.
With, doing your bring it down. Yep.
All right, and nine, up to nine command points.
Yep.
Okay. Command phase buffs, it's probably going to be pretty much the same. These guys can chain plus one to hit on the Hyrule. Maliceptor and Warlord, I'm still within 9 inches for the Warlord buff.
Alrighty, chat, so... Let's have a bit of a chat about that turn. It was massive. So Rowan traded the Dimmy to take out the Big Knight and two War Dogs, which was huge. It was such a huge turn, such a big trade. But now Tim has fought back. He's moved down this bottom flank, got the War Dog there, and dealt with the warriors that were there. He's then got two on each of the objectives, which is fine. The thing is that there's one individual knight and two knights there. But the thing for Rowan is that he's still kind of controlling this, and he has to go forward still. Now, because it is hold two, hold three, hold more, both of them are only on a three, so they're only going to be scoring 10 points. But what they need to also do is still hurt each other. But what's going to happen is that Tim is going to struggle because he's going to want to move forward and deal with stuff and try and get... But he also needs to score objectives, right? So he can't move forward with some of these units. So some of these individual ones that he's got, he's going to start to move up. Now, as we heard, he did not score, grind them down that turn. But we'll see what happens going from here. I really think that Tim is going to be able to claw some points back here by being on three, at least three. And then I think Rowan, as we can see, is starting to move things up. I think he's going to need to start really killing stuff, doing some shooting, and doing Rod. Rod's going to be a lot of points for him. He's already done it once. He needs to do two and three. At minimum, he needs to get at least 8 points on it. Stranglehold, he needs to start contesting. From this point forward, at least turn three forward, he needs to be contesting. I really think Rowan is in such a strong point from this point forward because killing the big knight with Jimmy turn one and trading it, definitely worth it. So let's see what else Rowan's going to do this turn. I reckon it's going to be a great rest of this turn, a great rest of the game. Thank you so much to everyone for joining us. It's awesome to have you with us for the coverage. And let's head back to the players.
I'll see if there's some room in this back corner.
Yeah, I think it would be.
Like, I'm happy just to put him wherever I can get him. Obviously a bit further than that. Yeah, cool. He's there. He's just going to rod in that quarter.
Yep.
And that's going to be my movement phase done.
Yep.
So I'll do some psychic now. Five tyrant will smite.
Okay.
That's an 8. Yep. D3 mortals to that front dude. 3. That'll be the only smites that'll be in range.
Yep. Down to 9.
Alright. His other spells, he'll cast Catalyst. 5 up feeling like pain would be pretty cool. I fail. So no Catalyst. Don't need Catalyst. Okay.
Don't use your crutch. Don't worry about Catalyst.
I won't. It's really easy just to all of a sudden lose all your CP with this army, so I'm trying to show some restraint. Trying.
I know. Don't worry.
All right, he's done. I'm going to cast Onslaught from the Maliceptor. He gets +1 to his cast. I get it with a 10. That'll go on the Hive Tyrant.
Yep.
So he can advance when I double move him. And then he's going to smite out of range. The Swarm Lord is going to cast... he'll cast the 4-up Invuln spell. I get it with a 6 just. That'll go on the... the Tyrant effect. So 4-up Invuln on him. And then his other spell will be D3 extra attacks on a 6. I get it with a 10. So the D3... it's going to go on the Hive Tyrant. The D3 is going to be 3 again. So,
oh yeah, I'm on eight. Yep. Yep.
I've just.
I'll put him. Moving to here. I don't know if that helps.
Did you want a D12 or something just to distinguish? Or
nah.
Feel good?
They're all different coloured. So yeah, true. They're fine.
So that's 3 extra attacks on the Hive Tyrant. He'll now have 7 instead of 4. I don't think he's going to kill much with it, but he's going to try his best.
You're on the D6s or D12s, and just.
Sorry?
You're on D6 or D12s.
So. I know.
No drivers.
Like I said, it's those magnets Scott put under there. He turns them on for me and off for you. Movement. Psychic's all done. It's just a movement. The Tyrant effects, he's just going to put his flamer into that guy.
Yep.
Just do it all at once. So it's going to be 4d6 auto hits.
Mm-hmm.
It's 20.
Yay.
I'm going to start using your dice.
Awesome.
Because this is feeling pretty
don't worry about
corrupt.
It.
So that's 12.
What's the AP, sorry?
AP
1. Ah, cool.
So that's 6, 12, 18. So their strength 7, so they're going to be winning on 4s.
Yep.
Doesn't look great. It's a lot, but a lot of fails as well. Okay, that's 9 at minus 1. They are D3 damage each.
Oh. 4 up saves.
I'll go on then. Oh. So you fail 2.
Fail 2? 2 damage through?
That's, yeah. Not bad.
Don't you touch my dice.
Yeah, Carl, yeah. It's going to be 4 damage. Sorry.
No, it's all right.
Suggesting that...
It's okay. It's fine. Down 8.
Okay, cool.
I'm only joking.
No, good.
Let's go.
Good turnaround. Cool. This lad. Cannons into the damaged war dog over there.
Yep.
Still plus 1 to hit from the buff, so 12 shots hitting on 2s.
Yep.
He's at AP 2. Same as before, 1 miss. Strength 8, so wounding on 3s.
Mm-hmm. Some really hot dice from Rowan coming in here.
Pretty few misses there. That's 6. 6 at minus 2.
Ion shield.
Nice, dude. 3 go through?
3 go through.
So that's 6 damage. Which is... he's
from
still what? They're 2 damage each.
Oh, that's the barbed guy.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were fighting with the hive guard.
No, not yet.
Sorry, my mistake.
No,
so he's on 3.
Yeah.
Got 3 left.
Okay, that's pretty cool. I will shoot the hive guard now, because that's the next thing I have to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to spend a command point for Relentless Flurry. Every 6 I roll to hit is an extra hit. So I'll go down to 8. And then it's going to shoot this guy.
Yep.
Rotate.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I might as well try it.
Yep. I'm just going to see if I get a command point. I don't. So, 12 shots, 3s rolling 1s, 3s rolling fails, exploding 6s. Reroll all this garbage. 2 6s so far. Yeah, 2 6s. Okay, a few more 6s. So that's 4 6s, so 1 miss. I'll add 4 more dice in.
Yep.
All right. 3s. 4, 8, 12 go through. Ooh,
take
again,
one,
spicy saves.
2, 3.
Yeah, cool. Why not, eh? 3 damage. I will be able to re-roll it, but not killing him. Nice one, dude.
Thanks.
Saves coming in big. I'm getting so many wounds from you.
Yes.
Like, I don't care.
Yes.
I'll re-roll the 1, so that's at the moment 5.
Yep.
6 damage. Good on you, man. Wow, awesome. I'm going to spend 2 command points to fire them again and just hit the same target. I need that not to be in my back lines. So I'll still have the exploding 6s and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, they all hit, and it's 5 6s.
Yep.
But at least this guy's making me spend a lot of resources to kill him, right?
Yeah, that's my consolation prize. Yep.
All right, R3s. R10. Yeah, 10.
All right. I've done this before.
Let's do it again.
We've been here before.
Exactly.
It's less good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 go through.
Nah. So he will go down. Okay. And the last thing I'm going to do is just tell the Swarm Lord to move. The Hive Tyrant to move again, and he will advance plus 4, so he will go 20 inches.
Yep.
Yeah, cool. So I'll just get over here.
Yep.
All right. Shooting phase over.
Yep.
I'm not going to get Stranglehold. Or I'm going to try and get Stranglehold. But I don't know if the Hive Titan can kill 2 of those dudes, but he's going to try his best. I'm going to multi-charge both of them.
Okay. I'll overwatch with 1.
Sure.
Doesn't matter which one. Oh, yeah. I'll do overwatch with a non-bracketed.
The full health one.
Actually, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it's 6s anyway, right?
It literally doesn't matter. Anyway.
Right. You're overwatching with 1 of them.
D3 shots?
Yeah.
For 1.
Okay.
Hits on a 6.
Okay.
No. Melter gun on top.
Yeah.
I'll use my free reroll.
Yep.
No.
Okay.
No 6s.
Okay.
Push him in or what?
A 5.
Push him in.
Okay, I'm going to do the finisher charge, spend it's breaking through to do some mortal wounds on the charge. And I'm going to target the guy on 3 wounds.
Yep.
Okay. So I roll how many dice wounds I have left. My strength is 6 and your toughness is 7. So every 5 up will be a mortal.
How many wounds? Oh, I haven't hurt him, have I?
No, he's 12.
No, he's got 12, yeah.
But I do need 5s. But you only have 3 wounds, so. Yep.
Rowan could kill the second knight here. Let's see what he does.
1, 2, 3, 4,
yep.
5.
Yep, executes it perfectly.
That will take him down.
Yep, can I explode?
Nope. And I'll just fight him.
Yep.
So I'll have 7 attacks. Hitting on 2s. Strength is 6 though, so I'm wounding on 5s.
Yep.
But I get to reroll for monster rending claws.
Rending claws, yep.
So 2 go through so far.
Yep.
Okay, so there's 4. Now these ones are minus 6 AP, just 3 damage.
So they just go straight through.
That's minus 3 D3. So I need to roll max damage if you fail this to kill him.
Minus 3 D3.
Yes. I don't have obsec there. So if he lives, I will not get strangled and you will. Yeah.
I'll CP it. I think it's pretty big if I roll this 6. So. Mm. No.
All right, D3 damage. 1. That's fine. 1 damage, so he's down to 2.
Yep.
Again.
Five attacks back.
Yeah.
5s with a reroll. Oh, yeah, it's going great.
Okay.
Oh, that's really big right there, ladies and gentlemen. Really big.
Strength 12 down to 4s.
So winning on 4s, yeah.
Okay.
That is going to be me. I do not get stranglehold. I killed 2 knights, I think.
2, yep.
Yeah, so that's another 4 for bringing it down. So that, I'll count it later. And I've rotted twice now over there. No, the lictor's done it, so I'll be at 4 for Rod.
Yep.
And over to you, mate. So you still hold 3, so you get your 10.
Yep, thank you.
I went first, which was pretty bad. I think whoever went first was going to take a big lead. And I managed to kill the big knight, and that was sort of a good start. I feel a little dirty. Yeah, I feel a lot dirty.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that again, huge turn from Rob, being able to take out a couple of knights there to be able to maintain. The lead that he's got. He's up to 38 points compared to 24. That is including Tim's primary for this turn. I agree, Squint Dog. We're going to need some Flex Seal because that's a lot of damage. Yeah. Yeah. I can confirm there is no magnets underneath the dice tray. Anything like that. There is nothing. There is nothing there. So it's perfectly fine. I reckon Tim. And Rowan was right, as he was just saying. Whoever got first turn was going to take a massive lead. And that's exactly what's happened here. Rowan has taken a massive lead because he got to strike first. But it's not about how hard you first hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep on going, which I think is going to be really important for Rowan in this matchup, to keep on going strong and to keep on going, as we've actually seen. Tim is still pressed up and moved forward, so he's not hesitating on sending out a couple of knights, but the thing is that he's just backed off this objective. And he's got the 2 there, that one looks to go that way now. He's still got this guy here that is gonna move in either of those directions. It's going to be really interesting to see how forward this goes. T-Sizzle coming in with the Prime sub. Thank you so much, and welcome to the first company. Great to have you with us. Hope you're enjoying the coverage. I really think that from this point, Tim has to... His dice have to start rolling hot, and he has to make every play count. Because if he doesn't, Rowan's going to start pulling away here. And considering that he's Rowan has killed and left, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 knights. Killed another 2 knights. That's another 2 points on bring it down. And also means Tim has to kill 3 units now. And that's getting harder and harder for him to do because his weapons are high, low amount of shots, high damage. So he has to execute on it. But we're going to turn back to the players. Seems like Tim is getting into a shooting phase and we'll go back from there. I hope you're all enjoying the game, ladies and gentlemen, because I certainly am.
Oh, wait. First, he's going to shoot the Hive Guard while I can still see that gun.
Yeah, you can. Still. I was like, hang on a minute. Wait, no. Yep, that's fair.
Yeah, I remember I did that for a reason.
Yes.
All right. 12 shots.
Yes.
With a reroll.
Yes. Nice shoots. Some sixes. Two sixes.
So 2 sixes, another 4 shots. Not 4 hits.
Very good.
T5, you said, didn't you?
Correct, and your strength 6. So, 4 threes.
3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 saves.
And they're AP 1.
AP 2.
Yeah, cool. So I'll have 4 ups against that. That was 9.
Yep.
So, ignoring AP 2, so 4 ups and damage.
No, so you. What do you mean 4 ups? You're on your invar, aren't you?
I ignore AP 1 and 2. And I have a 4 up.
Oh, ignore AP. Yeah, of course you do. I'm an idiot.
But it was damage 1.
Damage 1,
okay,
yeah.
Well, 1, 2, go down.
Okay. Yes, sorry. I know.
No, you're okay.
I've got a pretty short-term memory at the moment.
Well, I think you're still going to be able to. Yeah, you can still see.
Yeah, that guy.
Yep, agreed.
He'll go at him. I've got a 36-inch. I'm pretty sure I'm good.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, you're cool.
Reroll. Not great. Another 2. Ah, it's all right.
Okay. And 3.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Okay. 7 4-ups. I fail 2. So 1 more is on 1 wound.
Mm-hmm.
Going to be this lad back here because he's the one bit that's been giving it away.
He put his thermal lance into them.
Into the hard guard, cool.
And
melter,
and melter into the Tyrann effects.
Okay, cool.
So D3 shots.
Yep.
4-2.
Yes.
And I'll get a reroll.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Hits.
And 3.
Strength 8.
Okay.
1 wound.
5 up in bomb. I fell. So that one, the back goes down.
Another 1 wound guy.
3 left.
Yeah. Melt a gun. Doesn't hit. Okay. He's fallen back, so we'll do these two now.
Yes.
We'll do this one going into the hive tyrant.
Yep.
D3 shots. All guns.
Yes.
For 3.
Very good. Yep. No negatives or anything.
With a reroll.
Yep. And this will be wounding on 4s. It's minus 1.
Minus 1. 1 through.
4 up in volume. Fell. So
D2, D6, yep. Pick the highest.
And then -1. So it'll be 4 down to 3.
4 down to 3, yep. No
yep.
problem.
So I'm on 9.
Melt again on top.
Yes. Very good.
It's. No.
No.
Next one, same target,
yep.
Same guns.
Two shots. 2 hits.
2 hits.
No wounds.
No wounds. Melt again on top. Hits. Doesn't wound.
Okay.
I've got one more lightning lock Moirax that's going to have a crack at him.
At the hive turret?
This one here.
Cool.
Yeah.
So strength 6, right? You will be wounding on 6s.
Ah, well.
I don't know if you wanted to go here instead, but I mean,
nah.
Look, you do you.
It is what it is.
Yep.
Did they reroll?
Just good. 2 sixes.
2 sixes, yeah.
Nice.
And 6s.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 at -2.
Okay. I was like, yeah, 6s. No worries. I'll be fine. 6 at -2, so 6 4-ups. Which I'll make 2. Suspense is killing me. Looks like 1 more. 3 more damage. I'm down to 6. Nice one. That's, yep, very good.
All right, and charge.
Yep.
He'll charge him.
Yep.
is in.
Yeah, he is.
And the second guy's going to charge him too.
Sounds good, man.
He's in too.
Yeah, for seven. Sure. Okay, let's see if I can tank it. Your strength, 12. So be winning me on.
And he's going to charge.
Oh, of course, yeah. What are you charging?
Well,
you can try and get both.
I've just got to check if can I get past him without being within an inch. That's what I'm not sure about.
I think when you're charging, your movement is okay as long as you're not ending within it. Oh, I could be wrong.
You can't go within an inch.
Okay.
But I think I'm okay.
We can move him if you want. You know, just test it. Just put a couple of dice around him. Where he
okay.
Is.
Well, if that's the front of the base.
Yep.
That's where we're measuring from.
Yep.
So I'm just trying to look. Can I? I think I can.
That'll be out of an inch of him. Yeah. So you're good to go.
So I don't have to declare him.
No.
That's all I'm trying to do. I don't want to declare him with a flamer.
No. That's fair.
All right. So I'll just declare the Warriors.
So,
yes, sir.
Just having a bit of a couple of questions about this, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
So
it's defense. It's like defense. All right. So
they're considered barricades of fuel pipes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So being, where is it?
Lab.
Defensible. First one.
I'm pretty sure. Defensible. So if within 2 inches of the enemy.
Yeah.
Move against it. 1 inch.
Yeah, so I'm within 1 inch of it, so you can charge the barricade as long as you end up within 2 inches.
Yeah.
That's correct.
Okay. So just to help clarify the situation, because I know there was a couple of questions.
No worries, appreciate it. Thank you.
So 2 inches of him.
Yep.
He's going to be like 6.
Yeah.
If it's close, we'll double check. I think 4 won't do it, yeah. Have I gotten a CP from you this turn?
Sorry?
Do you know if I've... It's turn 2, right? Do you know if I've... I got on turn 1.
I can't remember.
That's all right.
I don't even know if I got a CP this turn. I think I did.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Cool.
Reroll. Yeah.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. Look at that. Really needed it.
Yeah. Yep. Bring it on. I reckon you can take him down.
Yeah. He's got 6 left, right?
He does. Four pinballs. Nice.
I'm using an Iconoclast strat. I can't remember the name, but I pick a unit I've charged.
Mm-hmm.
All my guys reroll hit against that target.
Makes sense.
So they both get the rerolls.
You want to do them together at the same time? I'm not going to interrupt, so you just do all your attacks.
Interrupt?
No.
All right.
I won't.
If you're not going to, I'm happy.
You're going to get me to bottom bracket, so there's no point.
So, threes with 4 rerolls.
Yep.
They all hit.
And strength 12, winning on 3s, minus 1 wound, winning on 4s.
Yep. It's only 1, 2, 3.
Okay. And they're flat 3 each.
Yeah. How many you got left?
I've got 6, so I need to fail all of them because I'm minus 1 damage. That was a rough wound roll.
Yeah, it's a bad roll.
I make 1, so I'm down to 2 wounds. Damn, that was, like, with all those hits, right? Like, yeah.
Oh, well.
I'll fight you back.
10 hits, 3 wounds.
Yeah.
yeah, alright.
So I've still got my extra attack. I'll just put it into the...
Definitely some rough dice rolls for Tim. He needs his dice to start coming hot and quickly.
So I get 3. Strength. 6. So 5's rerolling. Just 1 at minus 6, 3 damage.
Go straight through.
Yep.
2, 9 wounds left. All right.
Okay.
I think I needed that and that to get grind, but anyway.
Correct. Because I don't think you've finished any units.
No.
Off.
2 for engage.
Yes.
That's it.
Okay. All right, I'll go up to 6. I'm only on 2.
Yeah.
Start of my command phase. I'll spend a command point to make this guy OBSEC. So he's worth 14 OBSEC models on that.
Yep.
So I'll get 10 instead of 5.
Is that scored? When's that scored?
So you score primary at the end of the command phase.
Oh, do you?
Yeah. Right. So that's why that's such a good sprout, just because I can flip it if I need to. I was planning on doing it with a hive tyrant.
That's huge there for Rowan right then.
A total of 10 models. Oh, no, yeah,
so it's huge. Absolutely huge. So right now, Rowan is still heavily in the lead. Tim is forward back a couple of points. I'm going to get the points updated after this, but really what I think needs to happen right now. Let's pull up the green screen and I can kind of do some strategizing of what I reckon should be happening. So the failed charge here, well, no, he actually didn't even charge because of the barricade in all flamer. So that's, not fine. But having these two war dogs come in and not kill that hive tyrant is huge for Rowan. Even though they still hold it, it means that he's still tying them up in combat because they're not titanic. They can't disengage and still shoot, which is huge. Rowan then doing that obsec strat right there to be able to still hold that to get 10 points is, again, huge for him. So I really think Rowan, as he's doing, moving up that Hyrule because he wants to reinforce that point, because I reckon he may try to save this Hive Tyrant. As you can see in this top corner, there is a Lictor there as well that's probably going to do Rod. It probably did Rod last turn. And he's probably going to bring another Lictor to do Rod again this turn. So really, I think, he's probably got warriors sitting on this objective here.
Okay. I'm going to
the warriors here moving out this way. Or it could be a Lictor down there, I'm not sure. There's something there. Maybe the Malceptor even. I can go for a walk in and I can have a look. But moving up, I think this in this direction is the smarter move, because he does have three knights right there, two on the objective, one that's coming around the flank. So if he deals with this knight first, it means that Tim is just individually feeding him units because he's got to stay on those objectives. Whereas if Tim was to be able to send multiple knights simultaneously in the one area, overwhelming Rowan's firepower, then it means that it's target saturation. He won't be able to kill everything, and he'll be able to actually get some stuff in combat. Now, the Hive Tyrant is going to fall back out of combat to allow the Hyrule to shoot in there, which makes complete and utter sense, because then even if he gets them off the objective, kills them both, what that'll mean is that then Tim is only going to score 5 points. And next turn, the Lictor coming in, and I reckon it's going to go right there to do Rod. So a lot of stuff going on this turn. I'm going to update the turn, CP, all that kind of stuff right now. But it's about to get into the psychic phase, so we're going to turn back to the players here. Hear what Rowan's doing during Psychic's phase and the rest of his movement, and I hope everyone is enjoying the coverage here. It has been phenomenal to bring these games to you, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you are enjoying them.
In the wall, so, and yeah, the other Elixir, getting over to you. Somewhere. Yeah, cool. So he's just going to Rod over here.
Yep.
So that'll be my third. Cool. I'll do some Psychic. He fell back, he can't cast. Over here, the Swarm Lord will start. He'll go for a smite, which will hit him. Which is a 7.
Yep.
So D3 to that guy. 1. So he's down to 7. And then the Swarm Lord is going to cast.
Oh, you're right. 10. Up to 11 to bring it down. I think that's about right, isn't it?
I believe so.
Yeah. He's rotted, hasn't he?
He's rotting now.
So you've got three rods done then?
Correct. I've done here, here, and your one, so that's all that's left over
so
here.
So that's 8 points for Rod?
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. What was that to? So I've smote with the Swarm Lord. His next spell will be D3 extra attacks. I fell. Okay. And then the Malaceptor is going to cast Onslaught. He gets it with the 12.
Yep.
It'll go on to himself.
Yep.
And then he's going to cast Smite. He gets it with a 9. Or, yeah, 9. Mm-hmm. D3 into him. Just another one. Chipping away. Okay. Cool. Yes. Of course. Sure thing.
No worries. Thank you.
Okay. That was my psychic phase, so I did two mortals and onslaughted the Malaceptor, so you can advance and charge.
Yep.
Shooting. We're going to shoot those three Hive Guard into this gentleman over here.
Yep.
Should have range for that.
Yeah, it should be. 36, aren't you?
Yeah, that's heaps. Yeah, I'll spend one command point to have exploding sixes. Yep. Relentless flurry. So it's only gonna be six shots. Hitting on threes, re-rolling. Oh, Jesus, it's sixes. All right, so three more go in. Strength eight, winning on threes.
Oh, you spent the points on flurry?
I did, yes. Three.
That's less good.
Yep, for me. Oh.
Save them all.
That's well done. Nice work. All right, that's okay. That's cool. All right, Tyrannofex first flamer volley into this guy and his spine banks as well. I didn't fire them last time because I forgot. So 2d6 auto hits. Seven. Strength seven, so wounding on threes.
Fours.
Four, sorry. Fours. Four go through.
They're minus one, aren't they?
Yeah.
Save two.
2d6, rerollable.
2d3, reroll.
Yeah. I was going to roll d3.
That's all right. Sorry. Yeah, I know.
I'll reroll it.
Six left, yeah.
Okay, so four goes through, so he's on two. Mm-hmm. Either way, I would have had to hit him again or something. Again, yeah. That's it, right? Four shots from his spine bank, sitting on fours. Nothing. Okay. I'll just go ahead and flame him again.
Yep.
2d6 auto hits. Nine. Six. Seven. Nine, 20 on fours. Pretty average. The sixes are an extra AP because of my reroll damage. So these will be your five ups, and that'll be a four up.
Five ups.
All right.
So, yeah, I think it's just dead.
Yeah.
Explosion. Nope.
Okay. The Swarm Lord will tell the Maliceptor to move again, and he's going to advance. So he'll move 11 inches. So I'm going to go 6 inches this way.
Yep.
And then 5 that way.
Yep.
So I'm here. And I need to spend some command points to kill him, so I'll spend 2 to fire the Hive Guard again.
Okay.
And I just... Yeah. Yeah. So still exploding sixes.
This time I'll rotate.
Yeah.
Oh, will I? You're probably going to kill him. I'll just leave it.
All right.
Pretty low chance.
Reroll the one. There's two sixes in there. So two more hits. And threes. All right. That's six this time. That's a bit better.
Who are we going to ask? Cinch. I need some fives.
Six fives up, sorry. Oh, yeah. Thinking about which god to ask.
Yeah.
That's good. Four, I think he's got a couple left, right? So minimum four damage.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. And the last thing I'm going to do, have I fired my high ritual?
No.
Okay. I will shoot him at the wounded warlock. Look, I'm happy to go on this. I am technically not supposed to fire again until the end of the shooting phase. So if you want, I can just stop my shooting phase now without shooting him. And like by the book, that's what I should be doing.
Won't make a difference. Don't worry. Just do it.
Thanks, man. All right, so 12 shots into the wounded guy. Six, nine.
But Jamie, a 13-inch charge now.
That's it. No shooting, but you charge. All right. He's still hitting on twos. Every time he misses one, he's doing very consistent work.
Yeah, he's doing good.
Winning on threes. He's doing great work. Six, nine. 10 at minus 2. Mm-hmm. Pretty good saves. That was a 5, yep.
What's the damage?
It's 2. So I think I've only just killed him.
Yeah, well, you killed him on full wound, so.
So he was hurt, actually.
He was hurt anyway, yeah.
Sure.
So explosion.
Oh, yeah, he was.
Yes, he explodes. D3 to the guy next to him for 1.
Oh, goodness me, that's massive again for...
All right, and then I'm just going to charge... For Rowan,
he's just slowly chipping away at the knights, slowly doing stuff.
Yep.
He's just grinding down the knights, and it's that mentality of he got to strike first, so he's been able to do the damage.
Zero sixes out of 12 dots.
Damn.
Sorry to waste your time, sir. You may charge.
Sorry that happened. Three inches. I think that's okay, but it's, yeah, cool. I'll just place it out. So he isn't the most confident fighter. He has three attacks.
Yep.
I didn't get D3 extra.
Yep.
He's hitting on fours, rerolling ones.
Yep.
His strength 7, minus 3, D6 damage.
Yep.
So hitting on fours, rerolling ones. One hit, one miss, two hits.
Yep.
Strength 7, so winning on fours.
Yep.
One wound hit, minus 3.
Nope.
Damage. It's D6.
Yep.
It's going to be E5.
7.
Alrighty.
Okay.
And that's, you can smash me back.
5 back because you charge me?
Yes.
Top bracket still?
Yes. So all hit? Maybe. Nice.
Yeah. There's the magnets kicking in.
2. Strength 6?
Yeah, strength 6.
Yeah, so T7, so 2 wounds.
Yep. No AP, it's just a combat weapon.
Oh, okay. 3 up then. I take 1. 1 damage.
Just busted out his combat knife, basically.
So I'm down 211 on him. And that's going to be me. So I'm on 3 objectives and you're on 2, so I'll get strangled.
Yep.
Take me up to 6, and yeah, we've done the rest for now.
Yep.
Can count some knights at the end. Over to you. You're on 2, so you get 5 primary. Is this
14? You've maxed bring it down.
Okay.
You killed 2 knights that turn, didn't you? Oh no, 3. 1, 2.
1, 2, 3.
And he died as well.
Yeah, yeah. I flamed him.
Not going to kill 4 units, that's impossible.
Look, there's 2 lictors.
Yeah,
I know,
but I'm not going to kill 4. Oh, actually, the Hive Tyrant might try.
And the Hive Tyrant's very low, yeah. And lictors, 2 more axes. I don't think they'll live there. T4. 4 wounds, 5 up armor, and invuln.
Yeah.
Although, I killed 3 knights, so we need 4 kills.
Yeah, exactly. Blow him. That's 1, 2, 3. Can't do it.
There's warriors.
I'm going to shoot. I'm going to somehow kill him with shooting in combat, so that's not going to happen. So forget that.
That is updated for the end of my turn.
Oh, it's stuck there. Whoops. My mistake. Oh, hang on, sorry.
No, you're okay. It's an awkward spot to move stuff.
Just going to have to try and kill some Hive Guard before he just perishes.
Yep. Making sure those melters do some work.
Do you mind if I reposition him? Sorry, just
go.
So he's touching there.
Yeah, go.
Just thinking about the whole objective.
Yes.
So. All right, do some shooting.
Okay.
He would go into the Hive Tyrant.
Yes, with everything?
With everything. D3 shots.
That's good.
2. Roll, 3 reroll. 2 hits.
Nice, and
4. 1 goes through.
4 up in bomb. I make it.
Melt again on top. Hits. And doesn't work.
No, sorry, it doesn't. I was like, yep, no.
Okay, we'll do that lightning lock there in your room as well.
Yes. Oh, okay. Okay, here we go.
Should have started with this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sixes.
So another 10 hits. Okay.
4, 5.
Jesus.
Sixes.
Yes.
Oh, that was less good. 2.
Okay.
I had like 20 noise.
Just reverse those rolls, right? Okay.
Wow.
4 ups.
Yeah.
I make 1. It's down to 1. You can charge me.
Yeah, it's true. And this lightning lock's going to go for the Hive Guard.
Okay. Sounds good.
Reroll.
Cool.
Didn't do anything.
Sixes?
Three sixes.
So
another 6.
One more. Nice. And these will be 3s. I'd like 1 Hive Guard to live.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay. 10 and I've got 9 wounds, so I'd like to make two saves.
Something, yeah.
Two saves would be cool. That was 10 total. All right, 2 5-ups. I make 2 foresight 5-ups, so 2 die.
Hmm.
Yeah, 1 damage, right?
Yeah, 1 damage, yeah. The last one is shooting into combat against the Maliceptor.
And they're, what kind of weapons? Assault?
They're heavies, actually.
So it'll be a minus 1. He's still top bracket. He's 7 wins.
Bit of reroll.
Okay.
It's 1-6, I'll just put 2 back.
Yep.
Those 2. T8?
T7.
Yeah, 5 anyway, no matter what. 2 at minus 2.
Okay, he's got his 4 up invuln. Which he makes 1, fails 1, down to 10.
That's it, so I'll charge your Hive Tyrant with Old Mate over there.
Yep.
He's in.
I'm assuming you're still going to want to touch the objective?
Yeah.
I'll leave it for you. Yep.
That'll do.
Cool.
Actually,
1 wound.
Can I do it?
You rolled like a 8, didn't you? So you can definitely get in there.
I just want to maybe and then pile in him to...
I can hit pretty hard with him. Just...
If I don't, he's dead.
Yeah, true.
I might as well tag
him. There's also the objective, though.
Yeah, but you'll kill him anyway.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I've got 2 objectives. That's probably all I'm getting.
Sure.
5 swings at him.
Yes.
Hitting on 3s with a reroll.
We're good.
Reroll.
Okay. And fault.
3.
Dead. Do I explode? I do. It's just going to be D3 mortals. It's going to be 3 mortals.
Yeah, okay.
One last little
right
here.
And I'll pile in and tag you, barbed.
Okay.
Oh, what a trade right there. Absolute trade right there. Getting 3 mortal wounds on the war dog whilst also dying in the process. Huge.
2 hits, winning on 4s, 2 wounds at minus 3. Make a save.
Last one.
So just D6 damage, 5 damage again.
Yeah. Down 2.
And then I'll fire with the higher jewel. So he only has 4 attacks. He'd normally be hitting on 3s, rerolling 1s because he has scything talons, but he still has the plus 1 hit buff. So 2s, rerolling 1s. 3 hits. He's strength 10, so winning on 3s. 2 at minus 3, and he's a D3 plus 3.
Right.
At least 8 damage.
Yeah. Explode. Nah.
Alright. I guess I'll consolidate.
Oh, that... I don't know whether that was the right play. I really don't know if that was the right play from Tim to consolidate in. I really don't. I don't think that was a good play at all, unfortunately.
Nothing
I don't think it was the right one to make there. But let's see how the rest of the combats go.
Okay, so you're engaging. Not with that guy being dead, actually.
No, I'm not engaging anymore. I think we can probably pretty much just work it out from here.
Sure.
I don't think I've... Because once he dies from everything...
Yeah, I think at this point I'll be able to shoot that over there. I've got 1 hive guard. He's going to do whatever he can do, but I'd probably move the swarm with him.
Once you kill him and him, I can't hold primary.
Correct.
So that's all I get.
Yeah. And I'd say I'd probably look at killing him by falling back or just smiting him.
What do I get for bringing it down?
4. Yeah, 2 guards worth 2 each.
4. That's all my engage. Never scored grind. That's all I scored.
Oh, sorry, man.
15. 4. And 8, plus 10, 33 is all I can manage. All
right.
45 primary.
So I won't max that, I'll get 12.
Yep.
And I'll get 12 for Rod 12. As well, so there'll be 6 points dropped.
Yep. Yep, so it's a 94.
Yep.
Just grab a photo.
Sure.
That's it.
Yeah, look, it comes down to first turn.
Yeah,
I'd love to have another go with you on first, just to see what happens.
Yeah,
It'd be cool if we could do that and just,
Because I can chip you. Even if I don't kill you, I chip you.
I'm not, and then look,
before you charge me.
If you're hurting, the big guy's not moving as far, he's not hitting as hard.
Yeah.
Like you said, and you've got that extra gun.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. They decided to call it there and just work it out from there. So to update the points for you at what it would have been at the end of turn five.
So sucks to have that as the last.
I sort of knew that was my, you know,
would have scored 40 points.
I had a feeling I wanted primary to fight the sisters.
He
because of my lightning rods.
We've gotten 12 on stranglehold. And but then
I've got a friend who has a very
maxed out,
almost identical list.
Bring it down.
Your nice list. So he runs a different big knight. And I don't know if he has. Oh, he's got a couple more axes too.
No, it wasn't a tabling. They decided to call it. Yeah. It was probably going to be a turn four tabling or maybe even a turn five. More than likely turn four though.
Same thing happened.
In terms of for Tim though,
and he did end up
closed him in. Second game, we drew at about 60 all. He just put one of the small knights in front of the big.
Okay.
On engage.
Or even two of them. Just so I can't
and
physically charge.
And grind them down. Yeah. So it ends up coming in at a total point.
He picks up a small knight, maybe two. And then he's right in front of your strength 16. So I think if you come up against this list, that is my biggest target. Not just because it's got a big gun, but he's giving you...
Is 94.
I just want to get rid of that. When I can't kill him...
Two.
If I can't engage him in melee, he's going to pick up something probably every turn. Right? So...
Well...
Or at least something
I looked at that and thought... Whether I lose the big knight, or whether I lose, say, two Moiraxes, it's basically the same amount of firepower. Like, it's not...
I think just having
94 to 33, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Because I probably...
It was a really good game to watch. I saw the knight. Saw the knight was there 1 minute. Next, it was replaced with a Demi. Yeah, 100%. 100%. Roland getting in that first turn, being able to move and go. I reckon if Tim had gone first, it might have been a bit more of a game. But there would have been a lot less. Turn one, absolutely crazy for Rowan to get in there and do it. These guys got done in an hour and a half, ladies and gentlemen. Not even. Like, that's how few models they had. That's how the game went, which was really awesome. So... No, they only went to... AJ's Mildura, thank you so much for the follow. Really appreciate it, and welcome to the chapter. They did count. They did talk about rounds four and five in terms of scoring, rather than playing it out. I should have that up there. So it will count as a natural conclusion and everything. So that's what it will be. It was. I will say Tim was a great sport about it. Absolutely great sport. Same with Rowan. About it, you know, there were several times where Rowan was apologized for a couple of things that happened and all that. Tim completely understood that that was the game. But both really well painted armies, and really good to see how Chaos Knights do against this. And you know, we had a comment earlier in chat, I think it was Calzone Gaming saying that the Art of War guys did test Knights into
generally, I won't.
Crusher Stampede, and that they didn't do too well. I think it depends on the build, and I think it depends on the player, because Rowan is very well versed with Nids. He's been playing it for at least 12 to 24 months. Yeah, 100% Ninja Lav, 100%, especially the circumstances. Yeah. Some army shots prior to setup. Yeah. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to wrap that up there. Though, I'd like to thank each and every one of you for hanging out. Yeah, T-Sizzle, got you there. I don't know why it's lagging on this one for some reason. Let's just go, I'm gonna hide that. It shouldn't go off. Thanks, Dragoon, really appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in. Just a couple of things before I let you all go for your day. If you aren't already following me and you do want to check out other stuff that I do, I don't just cover events, I do hobby streams and I do games of my own on stream. We'll have another game, actually. Sam, who played round one yesterday, is going to be playing against me on Friday, this coming Friday night at my house. And Ninja Lab, thanks for the follow. I will turn on the alert box for that. Hopefully it will... And Firesmoke40, thank you so much for the follow as well. Had to pull out. It was great to see some of the games to watch. Exactly, Foolish Monk, and that's why I'm here. Sir Eternity, thank you so much for the follow. Really appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, everyone, thank you so much for the follow. If you do want to engage with the community that I have built up here on Twitch in my Discord as well. You can see all the lists from the players that they used today. Jump in there. We've hit 100 members this weekend, which is absolutely awesome. You can talk about lists you're building, projects you're working on, chuck up photos. It's where you reliably see the... thanks, Sir Eternity. Really appreciate it. I try to do my best to come off as professional as possible with my streams and my content. So, you know, these videos will be created into highlight videos and posted up on my YouTube and Facebook, as well as the full bat rep size being posted up as well, just at a later date. I do painting sessions, games, Dungeons and Dragons, as well as a bit of extra content. But everyone, I want to thank you so much for hanging out with me, particularly throughout the issues of game one where it was a bit laggy and such, and we had to stop the stream, quickly restart it. And, you know, I do this for you guys. I travel to events to bring coverage of the Australian 40K community and to share about the game itself and the love of the game, because I love the game, whether you're playing casually competitive, competitively, or whether you're just a hobbyist and painter. I'm all about helping as many hobbyists as possible and sharing around the Warhammer content. The award ceremony, Big Wacko Jacko, is going to be at 4 o'clock, so it's about 2 hours away. But I won't be covering it. I'm actually going to take this time to actually pack down because I've got to travel an hour to my in-laws' place and then such. So 4:30 around then. I might record it though. Just get a tripod set up with my phone, do a video, and then I can post that up to the YouTube later on as well, which is absolutely awesome. We'll see how that goes too. But everyone, I want to thank you so much for all your support. You sound ridiculously wholesome and enjoyable. Not the content creator I'm used to. Sir Eternity, thank you so much. I do the best that I can. Also, going to pay out the prediction that picked Ron with Knights. Sorry, Rowan with Tyranids, I should say. So congrats to everyone who predicted Rowan correctly. Everyone, thank you so much for all the follows over this weekend. Thank you for tuning in. It's been absolutely awesome to bring you this coverage. From the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. I've been ScottyD49. Thank you for joining us, and I hope to catch you in one of my streams throughout this year. See yous.